Welcome everyone here on this beautiful sunny day in Vancouver, British Columbia. So we are here today to commemorate the end of the first mission of the ocean cleanup in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, as well as looking ahead on what's coming up for the cleanup, as well as for the first plastic that we have collected. At the ocean cleanup, our mission is to rid the world's oceans of plastic. And to do that, we really need to do two things. We need to prevent more plastic from reaching the oceans, but we also need to clean up what's already in the oceans. So of course, we're working on the prevention side. We've developed these interceptors that we just launched a month ago to catch plastic in rivers before it reaches the oceans. But that's not enough to rid the world's oceans of plastic. To succeed in that, you also need to deal with the legacy pollution which is already in the oceans today. And by far the largest accumulation of trash in the world's oceans is the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, which is out there between here and Hawaii. It's twice the size of Texas, contains 100 million kilos of plastic, and not only does it not go away by itself, it gets more harmful over time because it breaks down into these smaller and smaller microplastics, which can then end up in the food chain. So we have to clean this up. But you might wonder, well, it's 20 years ago that this patch was discovered. Why hasn't anyone cleaned this yet? Well, it turns out that it's actually pretty difficult to do it. It's obviously very far away. This area is huge, and it's one of the roughest environments in the face of the planet. We're talking about waves up to 14 meters in height, wind, currents. It's all such a hugely destructive environment, so doing anything out there is just really difficult. But after years of research and development, in September of last year, we felt ready to try and launch our first cleanup system towards the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, which we launched from San Francisco that year. Now, this was a critical milestone, yet it wasn't a celebration, because we knew that it was still very much an experimental system. There was no guarantee that it would actually work. I think I gave it something like a 30 or 40% chance of actually working first time around. And indeed, our expectations were proven right. We had our ups and downs, we had problems, we had structural failures, but eventually the team was able to take those lessons into account and actually get to a point that we had a system that was successfully catching plastic 2 months ago. So that was really quite an amazing moment, especially after all these things that we went through. And of course, around me, we see the sort of the culmination of those efforts. And definitely, it's seeing this makes me incredibly proud of what the team has done over the past years. And a huge thanks to everyone who has been involved and for getting us to this point that we actually have the first plastic back on land, which is, it just fills me with a lot of pride and joy. But then, of course, we succeeded in catching plastic, but we're not ready yet to clean up the whole garbage patch. So, as you know, the objective is to clean up 50% of the garbage patch in 5 years. And for that, we want to build a whole fleet of systems that are bigger, more efficient. And before we can actually deploy that fleet, we have this essential stepping stone to still fulfill, which we call system number two, which is going to be the first full-scale, fully operational cleanup system. And we're actually starting with the development of that right now. So as mentioned, we now have a system that's catching plastic, but there's still a few things that we really need to do where there's really still innovation required before we can actually clean the ocean, which includes long-term durability and long-term retention. So being able to retain the plastic for very long periods of time, those are the two main engineering challenges that we'll be working on for the coming year as we prepare for the launch of system number two. But then it's important to realize that for this cleanup to be successful, it's not just a technical challenge. There's also this other side of the equation, which is the financial challenge. Because know, you might have a technology that works well, but if there's no one to pay for it, it's still not going to happen. So, now ideally, you have some kind of model through which once those systems are out there, the cleanup can continue to pay for itself. I mean, that would just be perfect full circle. Now, as you know, we're also doing this work on the rivers, and there the situation is very different because the river is actually owned by someone. It's a national territory. There's somebody who has an incentive to keep that river clean. So there's actually this business case to do this. But for the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, that's not the case. And you know, that's why critics have always pointed out that even if you have a technology to do it, it's not going to happen because it's international waters, so it's no one's problem. But we disagree because we believe that this is everyone's problem. So everyone could be part of the solution as well. So over the past few years, we've come up with a plan through which we believe we can actually do this. And to explain our plan, I'll explain it by answering the two most commonly asked questions that we receive. The first question is, well, what are you going to do with the plastic? Now, of course, it's important to stress that the objective of this first campaign wasn't to maximize our harvest. It was really just to get to a point that we have a system that's catching plastic, really validating the fundamental principles behind the concept. Yet by doing that, we inevitably also collected some plastic, partly by the system, partly by the crew next to it on the boat that was monitoring the cleanup system. And so we have 60 big bags of 1 cubic meter around me here, filled with catch. And if you look inside of them, you see it's absolute garbage. I mean, this stuff has been in the ocean for decades. It's corroded, it's degraded, it has salt on it, it has algae on it. It's really complete garbage. Yet we believe that these bags hold the key to making the cleanup self-sustaining. Because this is not just any plastic. This is plastic from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, the infamous Great Pacific Garbage Patch. And you know, it's like the difference between a normal rock and a rock from the moon. It's plastic that has a story attached to it. And not just that, it has a purpose behind it, because now that it's out there, or out of the ocean, it won't continue to kill sea life for another decades or centuries, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to recycle this plastic, and we're going to turn it into beautiful, sustainable products, completely made from this plastic from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, and 100% of the proceeds going to the continuation of the cleanup of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Now, we're these are not going to be gimmicks, you know, these are going to be products that you actually want. And we're going to try this out with the first plastic that we have here right now in the coming year to see whether this is actually something that can work, because you know, this is something that has never been done before. This will be the first product ever made from plastic from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. So success is not guaranteed. With this quality of this material, it's surely going to be a challenge. Yet, because of the research that we've been doing over the past few years, we believe that this should actually be possible. Now you might say, well, wait a minute, aren't there already a lot of products made from ocean plastic? Well, for that it's important to realize that right now there's no real standard, no hard definition of what ocean plastic means. So it's really kind of this murky definition, which could mean 100% plastic from the ocean or 1% plastic from the ocean. And even it's even possible that none of the plastic at all came out of the ocean. It's quite crazy. And what we believe is that it's important to bring transparency to the market. So we've been collaborating with the world's leading certification body, DNV GL, to set up a public standard which would be able to certify plastic that is actually coming out of the ocean. And they'll be sharing a bit more information on that in a bit. So what they've done, they've been following every step of this plastic from the moment it was collected from the ocean, and we'll continue to do so when the plastic is being sorted, when it's being recycled, all the way to the plastic being this beautiful, sustainable product. Which brings us to the second most frequently asked question that we received. Well, what are how can I help? How can I be part of this cleanup? Now, the fact, of course, is that the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is really far away, so you can't just go out there and collect some plastic yourself. So, through this plastic, through these products, we hope to give everyone the opportunity to be part of the cleanup. Now, the aim is to launch the first product in September of next year. But we already want to give our supporters the opportunity to join the journey of this plastic today. So if you go to our website, theoceancleanup.com, you can actually sign up for $50. And what you'll be able to do is you can follow the journey of the plastic, as well as be the first in line for when that product is actually being launched. So, and of course, because we're a nonprofit, 100% of the proceeds would already go to the mission. And with this, we hope to give everyone the opportunity to join us in turning this problem into a solution. Now, so once again, thanks for everyone who has been part of the journey so far. It's been a crazy 6 years, and I'm so happy that we finally have this first plastic back on shore. So thanks everyone who got us to this point, and I hope you'll be joining us in being part of the next chapter of the ocean cleanup as well. So, thank you. Sure.